So now that we've discussed what the genetic basis of cystic fibrosis is, let's try to generalize this notion to all possible variations within the human genome. So recall from the central dogma of molecular biology that you have DNA, which is the template for all of your genes, and then DNA is transcribed to what is called pre-mRNA, which is a collection of exons, introns, so on and so forth, where these exons are the only things that we express in the actual mRNA. So pre-mRNA is then spliced into regular mRNA, where these introns are cut out from between the exons. And then now this mRNA is translated into protein. And this protein is what basically functions in the cell. So we have variations in the human genome, or in all genomes, and specifically we'll be looking at single nucleotide variants, or SNVs. So a single nucleotide variant, or an SNV, is a location in an individual's genome that has a different nucleotide than the same position in the reference genome. So in this example, I have an individual has this G at the second to last position, whereas the reference genome has an A in that same position. So it's just variation with respect to your reference genome. And then a single nucleotide polymorphism, or a SNP, it's basically just an SNV that appears in a high enough frequency of the population. So typically, people use 1% of the human population as a good number to use. In addition to just classifying variants as SNVs or SNPs, we also want to classify them based on what function the given variant has. So SNVs can have three different types of functions. They could be a silent mutation, which it does not result in an amino acid change at the protein level. So the DNA has a mutation, the RNA carries the same mutation, but that mutation doesn't affect the amino acid sequence in the proteins. You also have a missense mutation that does result in a change of an amino acid at the protein level. So now the DNA is mutated, the mutation holds in the RNA, and then now the RNA actually results in a different amino acid at a given position in the protein. And then a nonsense mutation actually converts one amino acid in the protein into a premature stop codon. So a stop codon basically just tells the protein, it tells the machinery that's translating the protein, hey, this protein is done, chop it off here. And the result is an extremely truncated protein. So we have silent mutations, no change, missense mutations, a slight single letter change at the protein level, and nonsense mutations, which are significant chunks being cut off of the protein. In addition to these three types of mutations, we also have insertions and deletions. Basically, an insertion is something that an individual has an extra letter with respect to the reference genome. So for example, in this small example here, this blue A is in the individual, but it doesn't appear in the reference, meaning it was an insertion. And then also a deletion is when a removed nucleotide exists in the individual with respect to the reference genome. So the green G in the reference genome does not appear in the individual, so this is a deletion with respect to the reference. RNA is translated into protein three letters at a time. So each codon, each three-letter chunk of the RNA, codes for a specific amino acid. So as we translate the RNA three letters at a time, basically we can imagine this as reading an English sentence where every single word is exactly three letters. So in this example, our English sentence is the rat and the fat cat, something that makes perfect sense. If we were to delete or insert a single letter, so in this example, I'm deleting that first R in the word rat, then the resulting sequence of three-letter chunks no longer makes any sense. We get the, ATA, NDT, HEF, ATC, so on and so forth. Every single codon is still relatively conserved sequence-wise. It's just that we've cut one letter out, so everything was shifted over one spot, and this results in what we call a frame shift mutation. Every codon is now out of frame by one letter. So anytime an insertion or a deletion occurs in something other than a multiple of three, we get a frame shift mutation.